Hello learners, welcome back for the new video. In this video we will design the cascade aerator for a water treatment plant for a design flow of 10 mld. So let's start with the design. Here the flow rate or the design flow is given in mld, 10 million liters per day. Now we have to convert this flow rate into meter cube per day and meter cube per hour or meter cube per second, because further design process we have to assume some data, and that data need the flow rate in terms of meter cube per hour and meter cube per second. So let's convert this into meter cube per hour meter cube per second. So we know that 1 million is equal to 10 raised to 6 means 10 lakh liter per day, and I will break 10 raised to 6 into 10 raised to 3 into 10 raised to 3 so that it will be easy to understand. We know that 10 raised to 3 means 10 raised to 3 liter. 1 meter cube is equal to 10 raised to 3 liter. 1 meter cube is equal to 10 raised to 3 liter. That's why I will put the value of 10 raised to 3 liter as meter cube per day. Okay, here I have converted the value in terms of meter cube per day, that is 10,000 meter cube per day. Now I have to convert this value into meter cube per hour. So 10 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 24, it will come as meter cube per hour. After calculating this, you will get the value of Q in meter cube per hour as 416.67 meter cube per hour. Okay. Now again we need the value of Q in meter cube per second, so let's convert meter cube per hour into meter cube per second. 416.67 meter cube per hour. So we need to convert hour into second. We know that 1 hour is equal to 60 minute and 1 minute is equal to 60 second. That's why 60 into 60 per second. So the value of flow rate in meter cube per second as 0.116 meter cube per second. 0.116 meter cube per second. Okay. Now we have to find the area for the cascade aerator. So next step is determination of area of cascade aerator. So for this we need to assume the surface loading rate. Surface loading rate should be assumed in between 0.02 to 0.05. So I will assume it as 0.04. The unit of surface loading rate is meter square per meter cube per hour, and its range is 0.02 to 0.05. In between this value you can assume any value. I have assumed 0.04 meter square per meter cube per day. Okay. Now the formula for surface loading rate is area upon flow rate . So area will be surface loading rate into flow rate. So surface loading rate value is 0.04 meter square per meter cube per hour into, and the flow rate value is here we have taken the surface loading rate in terms of meter square per meter cube per hour. That's why we have to take the value of Q in terms of meter cube per hour. Okay, and that value is 416.67 meter cube per hour. Okay. Now after calculating this, you will get the area as 16.67 meter square . Let's mark it as A. This is the area of only cascade aerator. This is the area of only cascade aerator. Now we have to, we know that the cascade aerator, the typical layout or diagram of cascade aerator is like this. Okay, there is a central pipe in between the steps. From here the water will fall on the steps. Okay, so we have found the value of area of cascade aerator. That means the area of the area covered by the steps. We didn't assume, or we didn't taken the area which is utilized by the pipe and the which is also utilized by the shaft. This is the central shaft, and this is the pipe. And this area is considerable. That's why we need to consider this value in calculation for the designing of cascade aerator. So let's assume the velocity of the central pipe. Velocity of central pipe I will assume as 1 meter per second. And we know that the continuity equation or the formula for flow rate, Q is equal to area into velocity. The area is equal to Q upon velocity. Flow rate is in terms of meter per second, meter cube per second, 0.116 meter cube per second. Because here velocity is taken in meter per second, that's why we have to take Q value in meter per second, flow rate value in meter cube per second, divided by velocity 1 meter per second, and it will come as 0.116 meter square. Okay, this is the area of the central pipe. Now from this area we have to calculate the diameter of pipe, diameter of the central pipe. Okay, so you know that area is equal to pi by 4 into d square. Therefore 0.116 is equal to pi by 4 into d square. After calculating this, you will get the diameter of pipe as 0.384 meter. 0.384 meter. I will take it as 0.4. I will round up this value to 0.4 meter. Okay, that means the diameter of pipe is 0.4 meter. The diameter of pipe is 0.4 meter. Now we have to assume the thickness of the shaft. The shaft is located just near the central pipe. This is the shaft. I will highlight it is in so we have to assume this thickness. You have to assume this thickness. So let's assume the thickness of the central shaft. Is equal to 0.15 meter. So the outer diameter of the central shaft will be outer diameter of central shaft will be the diameter of pipe. Diameter of pipe is 0.4 plus the thickness of central shaft. Thickness of central shaft is 0.15, and the central shaft is located around the pipe. That's why we have to multiply this in by 2. We have to take the thickness of central pipe as twice. So the outer diameter of central pipe will be 7 meter. Okay, this is the outer diameter of shaft, and we have calculated the area of cascade. Okay, so now we will find the area of that shaft. Suppose I will draw the plan here, plan of that cascade aerator. This is the pipe. Okay, and this is the shaft, and after that the number of steps. Okay, so we have to calculate this area, area of pipe plus area of shaft. So the area of central shaft will be 4 into diameter square, and the diameter here we have to take we have to choose the diameter of the central shaft, that is 0.7 meter. So pi by 4 into 0.7 square, it will area will come as 0.385 meter square. This is the area of central shaft, and the and we have already calculated the area of cascade at 16.67, and we have marked it as A, and now mark this value as B. So see in this diagram we have calculated the area of cascade aerator. That means area of cascade aerator includes only the area covered by the number of steps. That means area covered by this step, area covered by these steps, and total area of the cascade aerator will be the area covered by the steps plus the area covered by the shaft. That means total area of cascade will be the summation of both area. That means A plus B. So total area of cascade is equal to A plus B. A value is, that means the area of cascade only 16.67 meter square, plus B value is 0.385 meter square. After adding these, you will get the total area as 17.05 meter square. Okay. Now again we have to find the diameter of total cascade aerator. That diameter includes the number of steps as well as thickness of central shaft and diameter of pipe. So area is equal to pi by 4 into d square. Area is 17.05 is equal to pi by 4 into diameter square. From this you will get diameter of cascade aerator is equal to 4.66 meter. This is the diameter of shaft. Okay, now see here, suppose this is the plan of the cascade aerator. Here it includes two steps, one, this is one, and this is two. Okay, and this is the central shaft, this is the diameter of the central shaft, and this is the thickness of the steps or the tread value. In steps there are two values, first one is the rise, the vertical distance, and the second one is the tread, that is horizontal distance. So there are two tread and one diameter of the shaft. We have calculated here the diameter of cascade aerator. Okay, the diameter of cascade aerator means this length, that means the total diameter. Okay, and now we have to find the number of steps which will come in this diameter. Okay, and we have calculated this diameter. For that we need to subtract this diameter from the total diameter. So total for calculating the total number of trade. So first we will assume the trade, assume trade length is equal to 0.5 meter and its value is in between 0.3 to 0.6. We know that step has two values. One is the horizontal distance as trade and another is the vertical distance as riser. Then we need to find how many steps will be covered in this diameter. So for but this diameter includes the diameter of cascade aerator plus diameter of shaft. That's why we need to subtract diameter of shaft from this value, and after that we have to divide trade length to that value. So number of so let's see how to calculate the total number of trade. Total number of trade is equal to diameter of total or diameter of cascade minus diameter of central shaft divided by trade length. From this formula you will get the total number of trade. So we will put this put all values in that formula. The diameter of cascade aerator is 4.66 minus the diameter of shaft is 0.7 divided by trade. One trade length is 0.5 meter. After calculating this you will get total number of trades is 7.92, round up it as 8. Okay, total number of trade is 8. Now see one important point is here. So this total number of trade here, there are 8 trades. So these 8 trades include the trade from both sides, from this side also and from this side also. So that's why these number of trade, the value 8, that means the number of trade is of both sides. So I will write here number of trade from both sides. So number of trade in one side is equal to 8/2 is equal to 4. Okay, this is the number of trade from for one side. Why this is required? This is required to calculate the number of steps in cascade aerator. Suppose this is a typical layout of a cascade aerator, let's assume. So in this diagram you can see here, this is not the trade, this is the diameter of the central shaft. Okay, so I will calculate the number of rise and number of trade in this diagram only. Rise is 1, then 2, then 3. Okay, total number of rise is 3, then trade 1 2 3. Here there is a collecting channel. Okay, there is a collecting channel, that's why I have not measured or calculated this as a I have not considered this as a rise. Total number of rise will be 1 2 3. Total number of trade will be 1 2 3. That means the number of trade is always equal to the number of rise. Therefore the number of rise is equal to 4. So this will required to calculate the total height of the cascade aerator. So assume the height of the cascade aerator, assume the height of one step or rise length as 0.2 meter and its value in between 0.15 to 0.3. Okay, So now we will calculate the height of the cascade aerator. The total height of the cascade aerator will be only the height of the cascade aerator. Height of cascade aerator will be number of steps is 4 into 1 rise length. Sorry, number of rise is 4 into 1 rise length is 0.2. The total height of cascade aerator is 0.8 meter. This is the height of the cascade aerator. Okay, now so I will show you the diagram for this design. I have already drawn this diagram on the paper. So this is the design we have made, and on the basis of that design I have drawn this diagram. So let's see, we have calculated the total number of steps as 4, or the total number of tread and rise is 4. So let's calculate. This is 1 step, 2, 3, 4 steps. The number of rise 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Then the thickness of the central shaft is 0.15 meter. Thickness of central shaft is 0.15 meter. Then the diameter of pipe is 0.4 meter. Diameter of pipe is 0.4 meter. And now we have to calculate the dimensions of the collecting channel or the launders. Okay, the diameter of the collecting channels. Sorry, dimensions of the collecting channel. So for these, we need to assume the velocity through the channel. Okay, we need to assume the velocity through the channel. Velocity through channel is equal to, I will assume same as that of the, as that we have assumed for the diameter, velocity through the central pipe, 1 meter per second. Then for the design of the collection channel, or the for the design of the launders, the design flow will be, half of the actual design flow. Because the reason for taking half value is because after because the water will be diverted to both sides, from this, for half water will be diverted to this side and half water will be diverted to this side. That's why for designing this and this channel the dimension will be the same, but the flow will be half. This channel will collect half water and this channel will collect half water. That's why we have to consider the flow rate value as half of the actual value. So a flow rate value is in meter per second, meter cube per second is 0.116 divided by 2, and its value will be QD. I will take it as QD. Its value will be 0.058 meter cube per second. So from, we have find the value of flow rate now, and we know the we have also assumed the velocity through the channel. So now again we will take the formula of flow rate. Flow rate is equal to area into velocity. Flow rate is 0.058 meter cube per second is equal to area that we have to calculate into velocity is 1 meter per second. From this you will get the value of area as 0.058 meter cube per second. This is the area of the collecting channel. So let's assume the width to depth ratio. So width, this is the width and this is the depth. Okay, so I will assume this value as 1. So we know area is equal to width into depth, and area value is 0.058 is equal to width, and depth value is also width, because we have assumed the width by depth ratio is 1. That means this we have assumed the channel is square. Then from this you will get the value of width as 0.24 meter. I will round up it to 0.25 meter. The depth will be the same, that is 0.25 meter. This is the design of cascade aerator. Thank you.